Well, we've been sent up there to retrieve this item that is coming from Mars. And it's a rover, and it's got within it some core samples, and in that core sample exists this, I guess, that's something that's sort of like almost pre-cellular kind of life. We're sent up there with someone who works exclusively with the CDC, somebody whose job is to make sure that everyone on board the ship stays uncontaminated, and make sure that whatever it is that we're bringing on board stays on board and doesn't come back down to Earth. In our film, we have a group of astronauts who are investigating what seems to be the possibility of extraterrestrial life in a very kind of practical, real way, not like in a like you'd find in a lot of sort of grandiose sci-fi films. So, but there's a real tension with that because they're handling it with such such a degree of reality. You sort of feel this this constant tension in the air of discovery, and that sort of permeates throughout the whole film as we, of course, learn more and more about this thing that we've put on board the ISS. At a certain point in the film, we discover that we sort of breathe life into it. You know, to almost use sort of a Frankenstein kind of comparison, we breathe life into it. We sort of feed it, and through varying temperature degrees and all sorts of scientific sort of mumbo jumbo that I wouldn't be qualified to explain, it's essentially reanimated. It comes back to life, and it's just this tiny little cell. But we learn to quite quickly how to grow it, and watch it kind of grow. And it's exciting. It's the most exciting thing that could ever possibly happen. And I think everybody on board the ship, on board the ISS, sort of feels like we're all standing at the precipice of true history, that we get to be the first people to report that there is, in fact, extraterrestrial life outside of Earth. And it's exciting. Jake is, he's one of the greatest actors of our generation. I mean, he's not only just to work with, but also just it's amazing to watch what he does. It's not every day I get to work with people that I consider a close friend as well. So there's a great deal of trust there. It's not a lot of actors that I feel like I would at the end of a scene, I would say, any ideas, any tips, any thoughts, any you want to help me out with some of this stuff. So it's great working with Jake. We don't really see eye to eye on a lot of stuff. I just sort of feel like, it's a close-knit group. She's sort of the newest one up there into the ISS. And what's interesting about the ISS is that, at least from what I've learned, is that sometimes hierarchy kind of dissolves quite quickly because there's so few people up there and they're in such close quarters and they have to be a family. And hierarchy doesn't really exist on an interpersonal level like that. You can't really be ordering people to do stuff and then you're asking them to fix the shower or eat lunch with them the next day. It's tough. So. She's the newest member, Rebecca's character, and she's up there in my character's idea. I think my character's idea of her is that she's up there for kind of a lame reason. Like, it's this, she's up there to, she represents caution, and my character has nothing to do with caution. It's kind of got a cowboy mentality. So she and I don't really see eye to eye very well on anything. But,